Today we are going to discuss a special instruction in 8086 called XLAT, that means translate. This instruction is mainly used in code conversion problems. That means you are going to convert a given code into another code, like binary to 7-segment display. So for a given binary, you are going to get an equivalent 7-segment display code, or for a given binary code, you are going to convert equivalent 1's complement code. For a given binary code, you are going to convert equivalent 2's complement code. For a given binary, you are going to convert equivalent BCD or equivalent gray code, or some problems like you are going to convert for a given binary number, you are going to find square of a given number, or multiplication of by 5, multiplication by 3 for a given binary number, multiplication by 10, addition by 10, some problems like this you can solve using this XLAT. This instruction mainly uses a technique called LUT. LUT stands for lookup table. So you will understand this technique LUT with an example. I will take an example. In the last class we have discussed about keyboard interfacing. In the keyboard interfacing example, we have seen that whenever we press a key and the corresponding key code is going to be placed in the AL register. So like that, if you place the key 5, then the corresponding key code is placed in AL register. That means AL will find the value of key 5, that means 05 will be displayed in AL. So the 5 code is going to be placed in AL. If I want to display this 5 on a 7-segment display, let us assume I have a 7-segment display and I want to display this one on 7-segment display. That means I want to display like this. On 7-segment display, I want to display this 5 in this manner. But if I give directly in this way, it don't display 5. What I require, I have to convert this 5 into equivalent 7-segment code. Then the display, 7-segment display, can able to convert, can able to display the value of 5. So how it will be converted? 7-segment display has 7 segments like this: A, B, C, D, E, F and G. So if you are going with this A, B, C, D, E, F, G, assume that this 7-segment display is of active low. So whatever the displays you want, whatever the segments you want to glow, that will be given zeros. So A is glowing, F is glowing, G is glowing and D is glowing, C is glowing, D is glowing and others are not glowing. That means you want to display this 5, equivalent 5 means this 0100100 is the equivalent 7-segment code. So 5 must be converted into this one. So equivalent 7-segment code for 5 is this one. If it is 01, for example, you are pressing a key of 1, by that time AL will be having a code of 01, that means only 1, that 1 is equivalent. The equivalent 7-segment code for 1 is only B and C segments should glow. That means B and C segments should be zeros and all others must be ones. So this is equivalent 7 segment code for this one. So we know what segment should glow for every hexadecimal code of 0 to F. So we are going to maintain a table. Okay. And this table is for 0, 0. Okay. For 0, for 1, for 2, for 3, for 4. Like this we are going to write till F. Okay. And internally we are going to write the equivalent value for this. Okay. Internally we are writing this is the memory address for this table, and internally the data is nothing but equivalent 7 segment code for that number. So this is called as lookup table, LUT, lookup table for this 7 segment display codes. So in this way we are going to form a table, and this type of table is used while converting a given binary code into 7 segment display, equivalent 7 segment display, that will be converted automatically by the system if you use XLAT instruction. So the translation from the code of the key pressed to the corresponding 7 segment code is normally obtained with the help of XLAT once the lookup table is readily available. Okay, so the lookup table should be readily available before using the XLAT instruction. So before XLAT instruction, AL will have the contents of 5, and after execution of XLAT instruction, AL will have the contents of 0100100. That means the contents of AL are modified with the contents of equivalent 7 segment code of the code previously it has. If AL has the content of 1 previously before execution of XLAT, now the AL will be replaced with the contents of 1001111. Like this it will be replaced. So remember that one, to execute XLAT, the lookup table should be framed first. Now we will discuss requirements for creating a lookup table. The first requirement is lookup table must be created in data segment only, and there is no restriction that where you should create the lookup table. You can create the lookup table at any offset address. So for example, you can create at the starting address of 0000 or an offset of 2000 or at any offset 5230, like this. Okay, so lookup table should be created in data segment at any offset. The second requirement is store the required equivalent codes for the corresponding codes present in AL sequentially. Normally we are going to convert codes of one nature to other nature, like binary to 7 segment codes. So first thing is nothing but the code is in binary, so first form is in AL, and again the converted form is also converted in, available in AL only. The first form is in AL and the required form is also to be present in AL. So the required form should be present in lookup table sequentially. Store the required equivalent codes for the corresponding codes present in AL sequentially. That means store sequentially the required equivalent codes for the corresponding codes present in AL. And the third requirement is the value present in AL before XLAT instruction is replaced by the contents of new offset pointed by contents of AL is added with BX register in data segment after XLAT instruction. That means AL and BX register contents are going to be added up and a new offset address is created in the data segment. At that position, whatever the value present, that equivalent 7 segment code or that equivalent corresponding code is transferred to AL. So what is necessary means we need to keep the base address of lookup table. Base address of lookup table means the first offset address of lookup table must be kept in BX register. So these are the three important points should be kept in mind before using the XLAT instruction. Okay, so at least you should remember, before using the XLAT instruction, AL should contain the code of pressed key in case of example of 7 segment display, and BX should contain the base address, that is starting address of lookup table. Okay, so for example, in case of our example of, so in our example of binary to 7 segment display, before using the XLAT instruction, we must ensure that AL should contain the correct code of the pressed key. Okay, and BX should contain the base address of LUT, otherwise you will get the wrong 7 segment code. Okay, it must be ensured that AL should contain the correct code of the pressed key and BX should contain the starting address of LUT. Okay. Thank you.